Hi. I'm Sam Conlin. This is Only Child Originals. It's a whole store of handmade stuff. Most of it made by myself and my coworker Andy. But we bring some stuff in. I went to Thailand in February for a bunch of clothing and purses. So we have many different types of things here. Recycling is a big theme in the store, so I have a lot of things made out of tomato paste cans and barn roofs.
Can you show us around a little, Sam?
Sure. We have all kinds of jewelry made right here in this building. The tin stuff is from barns around town and around Missouri. There's some lamps over your head there, Ed, that are made from barn roof. The racks are made out of driftwood from the Mississippi River.
Oh.
These purses and the clothing are from Thailand. There's some tin can stuff and barn roof stuff in the front window. Those can be hanging lamps or candle holders. Totally recycled, along with all the squiggled wire stuff above them.
How do you make the cutouts in these lamps, man?
I use a torch on some of them, an oxyacetylene torch, and on others I use an arc welder when I want a bubblier edge. That's a barn that my boyfriend and I tore down two summers ago now in Marquand.
All these purses from Thailand?
Mm-hmm. Those are made by the hill tribe people of Thailand, mostly Hmong hill tribe people.
Thank you. Couple of cats, huh?
Cats, dog, fish, ballerinas.
Butterflies.
Whatever you want.
After 7 years, I have finally used up all of my baby food jars from my son, Zach. So if anybody out there has any baby food jars or old barn roof that they want to get rid of, feel free to bring it here. I am your new local recycling center.
I'm Kara with Simple the Sassy Decor and More. We're a new shop in downtown. We are featuring some homemade crafts and deco wreaths. We have several crafts, mason jar crafts, small wreaths. We're setting up for fall now. We specialize also in deco wreaths and can customize deco wreaths to pretty much any event, any occasion. We are going to be working on redoing and repurposing some furniture. This was the first piece I took on, which we're using just in our shop, but we're going to be working on some dressers and nightstands and different pieces around the house to repurpose, so those will be coming soon. We have several different sections in the store. Even some stuff for some young girls. We have a little diva area and some crafts for the young girls. And then we also have some dishes and some local stuff to go towards the Fleur de Lis and the St. Jean heritage. So pretty much everything you see in the store is all for sale. Cycling items in and out with the different seasons. We're looking forward to Christmas coming up and doing a lot of event planning with Christmas and Christmas parties. Doing all kinds of Christmas decorations and decorating full Christmas trees for sale. And we are
help take the stress out of the holidays.
Yes, and we are having a grand opening celebration next weekend also.
Next weekend?
We have our grand opening event next Saturday, which will be Saturday from 10 to 6, and then on Sunday from 11 to 4.
Well, thank you for showing us around.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Gary Bursaw, the owner-operator of the Spirit House. My wife, Faye, and I both had this idea. We went to St. Louis and bought us a kit, made the kit. We entered it in the contest at the county fair and took a first place medal. Looked around, there was no place else close, so we started this shop. That's how it was brought about. We've had a grand time with it. I offer tastings of the homemade wines we make and the home brews that I make, which I make several here when I'm done. We offer anybody, the artists want to come in and hang their art on my wall. I'm glad to do it. Myself, farm, I will gladly do that. We have a basic stock of items. If you want to brew a beer, if you want to make a wine, we have kits. But a lot of guys come in that make their own homemade wine. And I carry the yeast and tannins and the pectins and the things they need to make their wine with. And if they come in and I'm not carrying it, next time they come back, I guarantee it'll be here for them. I'll stop the farm, you know. So that's a lot of times I don't have it when they come in. Had an old fellow come in and wanted a testing kit. didn't have one. But the next time he come back, he wanted the hydrogen sulfide, I think it is, that goes in it. Didn't have that, but I had the testing kit, so he just bought that instead. So if you come and check me, I'll have it next time you come back. I guarantee you that. But hey, we've been having fun with it. It's a good time. I'm trying to get set up back here in the back, where if you want to get the kit and have me make it for you, I'll be glad to do that. We'll set it up here in the back room. Anytime it's ready to have something done to it, I'll call you or email you or whatever. Come in and we'll rack the wine and bottle the wine together, whatever you want to do. But you know, we'll make you a wine here if you want to do that, which would be fun to do, I think. You know. So we are currently trying to get maybe some of the restaurants and bed and breakfasts, see if I can't make them a house wine for them. We usually make dry reds. And my latest efforts, the only time out of about 10 tries that I didn't make a decent one. So I call it my oxymoron wine because it's a sweet Chianti, which is no such thing, you know. So, but yeah, we're having a good time with it.
Show us some of the kits.
Pardon me?
Show us some of the kits you have.
Well, kits.
You live here now, though?
Okay. Well, this is a basic wine kit. It has the bucket, the big 6-gallon carboy, the hydrometers, the corks, the airlocks, all the stuff you need to make a wine with. That's the equipment kit. And then, well, this is a Pinot Grigio. That's probably one of my best sellers. I've sold about 4 of these already. But now this, like a Pinot, a Chardonnay, a Cabernet, Blanc, Sauvignon Blanc. And then I have the reds, Chiantis, Merlots, Cabernets. This Italian Brunello is probably the best one that I make, that I carry. It's a little more expensive, but it's a good one. I'm telling you, that's a great wine right there. So these are wine kits. You get the equipment kit, you get the wine kit, and if you stay on the directions any at all, I almost guarantee you you're going to make good wine. They're just not hard. It takes about 40 to 45 days to put out 30 bottles of wine with one of these kits. So, and if you figure the cheap wine up at the store is $5 a bottle, you know, so if you can make a good wine for $3 a bottle, you know, it's good. That's all I can do.
So if anybody's a little hesitant, you can help them along?
Oh, I would be glad to. I give a card, call me, email me. If you live here in town, I'll come up to, you know, come up and see what's going on with it even, yeah. These are what I call my captain kits. These are a no-boil beer. All you need is a bucket, a hydrometer in this kit. And some beer bottles, of course, but if you drink beer, save your bottles. It comes with caps and the whole business. It's about as easy a beer to make as you can ask for. So these other guys are cookers. You've got to have a boiler or a cooker to make them. And then, of course, we have the Mr. Beer. And this makes about right out of a case of beer. That's the kit, and these are the refills. It takes about 2 weeks, and you get... Well, I've got the Cerveza and the American Ale here in the icebox right now. The first 2021 bottles you pull out of there, or you could read the newspaper through that bottle. They are just as clear and pretty. You get into the last few, and I tip the thing a little bit to get the last couple of bottles as dregs come with that a little bit. You know? But yeah, they're fun. And we've had a good time doing this. I'll just tell you, I'm having a heck of a good time. I get people in, I tell them my story about first time I made the captain's kit and I had some blow up on me because I bottled it too soon. And almost everybody's got a story about grandpa's beer or uncle somebody's beer that went to blowing up one night at a time, you know. Almost everybody's got a story about that, so it's fun to tell about it, you know.
Thanks for taking some time.
Hey, thank you very much. Enjoy.
We're here now, see what we can do.
I know that doesn't do it justice, but it's awesome. Yeah, we don't do that to Jefferson Barracks. Well, I don't know if we're going to. I guess if much was required, here's one you'll be fine. Not much is required. I wouldn't offer. Yeah, because, well, only because if much is required, I have more chance to, you know, mess it up. No, I bought it from a artisan in New York, you know, Holiday Market. Not this one. I love this. Thank you. I feel very arty.
Okay, you probably.
Florence place.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay.
where they're getting it.
I know where I got it.
I'm Joan Burns. I live out in the county of St. Genevieve. I've been living in the area for about 25 years. Came from Iowa. Got started kind of late in the painting after my daughter left home and then kind of retired. And then I do this painting and of things I see around me, a lot of it is. This particular painting was next to our neighbor, and we were walking past the fence, and we saw this big black lump on the ground, and then suddenly it was out. And he told us, you know, took a picture
of it. Out of the country, New York.
And then later saw that he had cuts on the back. I don't have any paint, but big cuts on the back here. It looked like he'd been attacked by a coyote or something. He was just ready to fight, so he left. He was real interested in our dogs. But I thought he made a good job. This was just out of my head. I like mountains and waterfalls. And again, this one too is just something I made up. This is a painting of my daughter. She's about 2 or 3 years old in her grandfather's trying to feed the cattle. So,
your mother an artist?
There's just a lot of homey kind of things. Country. The different insects and bugs and flowers, landforms.
Are these your dogs or?
No, but my husband's real interested in the mastiffs, and I saw the some pictures of them, so I thought I'd put them together to make a painting of them.
mama
this feeding them? This one I saw, this was the rabbit made a nest in the barbed wire that we just left around a fence, around a fence post. And built a nest right in it, about this far off the ground. This one is, I made for, there's a women's group. My niece is a member of it for working with abused women and families, family violence and stuff. And she wanted a painting to do a auction to a fundraiser for their group to help women. So I did this one for her. Tried to capture a little bit.
I don't know. I can walk back in.
This is probably kind of political.
Thank you.
It's called Overlooked. At first I was going to call it The View, but Overlooked maybe captures it better. Blue jays. They built a nest in the crotch of a tree, and it looked like the whole thing was going to fall out. And they seemed to survive. It's just an eagle. A beautiful bird. I love the eagle. It's a fun one to paint. And this is the feed store over there by the tracks of the Tri-County or St. Genevieve Farm feed store. I saw a cat sitting there in the doorway one day. I was doing a plein air painting, so I painted that one. Just a big sunflower. My imagination. Another one that's just pretty much out of my head. I don't have to be out of my head to make them, but I like mountain scenes and snow. Just a close-up of the dragonfly. Caution, crime scene, do not enter. It's Wall Street coming out of the whole breakdown of the economy a couple years ago, That's our garden gnome. Sits in the garden. Guards the garden. Not too well, though, the rabbits get in. And another a scene that I saw once and liked. My husband came up with a name for this. They're dachshunds, but we called it paradox. We called it paradox. They're sitting there trying to get into their house, and there's nobody home. And that's the willow that never grew on the little island in our pond. We planted it, but it didn't grow, so I had to paint it to pretend it's there. And again, another just watered fall that I did on my head. That woodpecker slammed into our window, our bay window, and kind of stunned itself, and then went and flew over to a tree and just sat there. And my husband went out and took a picture of it. Got took in a few feet of it, took a picture of it, and I thought, that'll make a good painting. So it recovered and flew away eventually.
You asked a question earlier.
And that's our pond.
Oh.
that leaks too much. It should be really healed up to here. But it's a nice spot to go down. Another one I just made up.
Doesn't compete with this one.
Well, sometimes watching.
I like world scenes. I like to include all the farm animals in some shape pictures. That's our cat. And a very bold titmouse. And that titmouse would come and steal out of her food bowl. She's asleep. Sneak up behind her and grab it and fly away. They're bold. That's called the line. And it has no particular destination, but it's about people having to stand in line for so many reasons. And one of the points of it is that there are some people who never have to stand in the line. They go right to the front. They don't have to wait like most of us do. And this one is called Online Dating. There's a bird sitting up here. I don't know if you can see the little bird in the distance coming closer. All together, and then they start their home. And this actually happened on our electric wire out in the front field. And we have a little birdhouse on the light pole.
Yes, like that, exactly.
Hi, Tracy.
Hi.
You're a pottery artist. How long have you been involved in pottery?
Off and on, probably a total of maybe 10 years now.
I don't know why.
And how'd you get started?
My mother signed me up for some classes when I was very young. Yeah. Then I continued studying it while I was in college. I took a brief hiatus for about a decade and came back to it finally.
How do you find your inspiration for your pieces?
Most of my pieces are inspired by the main game,
what you can do.
Pottery, which is functionality.
That's cool.
And form, and just an approachable utilitarian wear.
All your pieces are.
That's cute.
They're all usable.
Oven safe.
Oven safe, microwaveable safe.
My mom collects teapots. I really would like to get her one. I don't want to walk around. We just started.
Some of these smaller pieces just use them. Personally, use the microwave quite a bit, and I don't like microwaving in plastic, and I tend to waste a lot of paper plates trying to cover my food, so that's why I started making these.
Oh, yeah, Dan.
So I try to,
I guess.
Your teapots are certainly unique.
Where
do you find the inspiration for those?
Just in some deep, and I think dark corner of my mind.
This one, I think, is the oil, too.
No.
Cute.
So you have all these in here?
All slightly twisted. I read a lot of science fiction and fantasy.
Well, I will definitely be back. I'm going to get one of these.
That's kind of what comes out.
What about this one?
This pit pot UFO one.
My whole family, we're obscure. It's obscure, we love it.
Oh, that's cool. Pretty. That's like the bottom part of it.
Mm-hmm. You didn't know that. Was that a whole set together?
Yeah, that's sweet.
Here's the name.
She's open.
So she's got to be 11, 12, 13.
And she says, after it was over, the mic, somebody didn't turn off the microphone, so you guys were still talking, and I heard you talking about your shingles. She couldn't even see, she couldn't see us, we were off camera, but they were still recording
your voice,
and they didn't play that back.
Yeah, well, maybe I had a bad case of chairs, and I referred to them.
No, but you wouldn't have, you wouldn't have shingles, you don't even think about shingles.
Anyway, I'll get there, it's somebody else like that.
My
he was talking that she thought she was hearing me. Oh, or
gosh.
I could have been being stupid with my kids. That, like those
so
guys, they bring out the stupid in him.
Hey!
Hello!
Hey!
Hey.
So
you
cute.
Got one more place so besides
we,
here.
Yeah, we need
girl,
to
girl, aren't you hot with them?
No, I'm actually content out there. I'm pretty
wow.
Hot.
Yeah,
it's
well,
pretty warm
here. We'll stay for a year.
I love yeah. Those runway pictures. Oh, thank you. I don't know. I think I took them off pretty soon.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, not because they were bad or anything. Just because
are you
taking
in a concert for
these are the people that are sending our son Eddie off to Germany.
What?
Yeah.
I didn't know all that. See, I'm not in school. I don't know anything.
Oh, wait. You don't know he's going to Germany?
I know he was going to Germany, but I didn't know it was.
We just traded him a favor. We just traded him a favor.
Which was why?
Then I know the whole story, and you guys are extremely nice.
No. No.
Let's see.
Eddie could do something that we couldn't do. some digestive stuff.
She's being really, really modest.
No, I'm not. We can't do what we want to do. We're gonna hire Eddie to do some landscaping for us.
Okay.
Build the retaining wall, and we wanted him to do it like.
73.
We started talking to him like early last fall, and I told him I wasn't in a hurry or anything, and that's why I said it all worked out great. And so Eddie came over.
Last month I had pictures.
He measured and everything for us, and then he disappeared. Well, unbeknownst to us, at Rick's show, Rick had a show, we had asked Eddie to play music for us, is when he met Carmen.
I'm working on re-editing this project.
Yeah, and we didn't know it, and that's why he was.
My name is Derek Gallagher. I live in Farmington, Missouri. I've been an artist for most of my life, always drawing. I picked up painting about 8 or 9 years ago, and it's oil paintings. My main medium now, it's always grabbed me. I've always wanted to try when I was little, and now it's my main passion. I mostly am a figurative and a portrait artist, but I also dabble in landscapes and other stuff. But I'll tell you about some of my paintings. This one is, I'm a big Star Wars fan, so I had to do this painting of Luke Skywalker. It's called Searching for the Jedi Within. And this scene on the movie, I just thought there was so much passion in the way he looked at the two sunsets. And this piece, I recently was in the Greenhouse Gallery Salon in San Antonio, Texas. And this was one of the gentlemen looking at my paintings. I took his picture in the way the lighting hit on is really interesting, so I felt like I'd like to paint that. And this painting right here, this is of a local girl that lives in St. John. Her name's Taylor. And, I can't remember the name of the park, but it's I got this painting of her looking on the bridge. This painting is of the ocean in Oahu, in Hawaii. My father, he owns a house down there, so I visit them frequently. This woman is from San Antonio, Texas. I got this at a Turkish festival. This lady, I found her complexion and the way she stared innocently into the crowd, pretty captivating. So I found that fun to paint. And then this one, this is one of the tigers at one of the local tiger sanctuaries that they have over at Crown. And then this is one of the chimpanzees at the St. Louis Zoo. I found the stance and how he was staring right at me. I found that very interesting, so I wanted to put that on the canvas. And here's one of the local reenactors that lives here in St. Or I believe he lives in St. John.
Guess where I'm going?
Yes, at a Heritage Festival, I believe it was. An Indian reenactor. And this is of two of my three children. I frequently paint them. This was at Sarah's ice cream parlor. And this is of one of my friends. Her name is Joanne Truss. She's a very interesting woman. She allowed me to paint this of her. This is of is named the Texas Garden. This is in San Antonio as well. This was actually at the Alamo. They had this in the gates. They all the cactus. It was aligned very beautifully. So I definitely wanted to paint that. And this was in New Orleans. There was three gentlemen sitting on a bench looking at people passing by. So this was something that I found just their stances and how they look like they're regulars to the spot. That's, I wanted to capture that moment. And this is my friend Anita. She allowed me to come into her home and get this over. She's a member of the St. Genevieve Art Guild with me, and we've been become good friends. And this is also exhibited in San Antonio, Texas at the Greenhouse Gallery Salon of 2013. This is my another one of my good friends, Paul Cameron. He belongs to the St. Gen Art Guild as well, and he's a reenactor. He allowed me to do this one, right? And then this painting is this was taken at the Riverwalk in Texas. One of the waitresses at one of the local Mexican restaurants was honestly happy to see somebody, so she is very perky and waving. So I luckily got that captured on film and was able to recreate that. This is my wife, Katie. This is a small portrait of some of the warm lights coming from the front and cold from the back. You want a one-man show? And this is of a. This is at the St. Louis Art Museum. That's my three children, Evan, Ryder, and Abram. It's called the musician, the artist, and the singer. They all have strong passion in the arts, and I wanted to capture that. And this is one of my son, oldest son, Evan, with a tie. I like the contrast of the bright red against the browns and blues of the background. This was a young man. He was a fisherman. I got a picture of him on a pier on the ocean over in Alabama. His eyes were had some great. You could tell that. This one's hard to see. This is one of my wife's friend, Aubrey. She posed for me one evening, reclined on the sofa. And this is my second oldest son, Ryder. One day he had one of my hats on. The way the light was coming through the window, it really inspired me to do this painting. It's named Wise Beyond Age. And this was also in the August issue of American Art Collector for the portrait artist directory. And this one was in Texas as well. This is a man feeding birds in the park. He looked like he this was something he frequently did, and I was able to get the be there at the right time. I thought it was a real good composition, and had something about him I really liked. And this is one of my dog. This is Betty. She loves to sunbathe, so I love to capture stuff that's in my life. So this is one of my family members. So I wanted to get that. And this is at one of the lakes at Elephant Rocks. I saw my mother and a child sitting by the lake, and it was a good composition. I wanted to capture that. Well, this is one of my friends, his name's Don. He started this mystl.com. It's a group in St. Louis. They have monthly exhibits at the Old Orchard Gallery in Webster Groves. He started this, and he's become sick now. And one evening, he played this guitar song for me, so I wanted to pay tribute to him with this. And this one up here is of Elephant Rocks. I've loved going on the trails at Elephant Rocks, and one evening lighting was just right where it cast the shadows of the two large boulders on top just right, and so I was able to get a good photo of that to work with. This was taken at a festival where a woman was painting faces. I'm not sure I wasn't sure what the subject of matter was, but she's really into painting faces. So. Here's one of, this is one of a long haul that connects to the Alamo in Texas. I just love the way the lights were beaming through the trees and up against the white walls. So it had a good glow to it. I wanted to capture that. This one right here is a self-portrait of myself. I have a rug that I love the maroon and green colors in it, so I felt that would be a good backdrop for a self-portrait with the white floor and the pink flowers. And this one right here is a gentleman reading on the street. I like the pose that he was in. And he looked like he was really into the book, so I wanted to capture that. So right here is my wife, Katie. This is in Alabama under one of the piers. It was at in the evening, so I wanted to capture the greens and the yellows that were shining through all the hotels into underneath the pier.
No, I gotta go out and play music tonight. I'm playing blues.
And this is a self-portrait of myself, drawing a sketchbook. It's an artist at work.
Thank you for watching Channel 798.
Thank you for watching Channel 798.